Hello, how are you? We're here again. Today we are going to see the relationships between living things. We are going to pay attention because there are different types of relationships depending on if they are between species or within the same species, okay? We are going to start by these intraspecific relationships. These intraspecific relationships are relationships within the same species. So, reproduction, the first of these intraspecific relationships. Living things of the same species breed to produce new members of their species. As you know, it's typical reproduction. We have studied it in unit number one. And depending on how is produce this reproduction, we can be viviparous if the baby is born from the womb of the mother, or if the baby comes out from an egg, it's an oviparous. Okay, it can be oviparous. Okay, so reproduction is the first of the intraspecific relationship. Now, protection and feeding. They are very related, closely related. We're going to see. Protection is when some species protect from predators staying together, okay? Here we can see a herd of wildebeest that stay together to procure themselves protections from their predators, okay? And here we've got, in the other side, the feeding, that are those predators that work together to hunt larger animals. If you see, these lions are just like the half of the wildebeest, but they work together to hunt the wildebeest and eat it, okay? So these are the three types of relationships that are intraspecific: reproduction, protection, and feeding. And now, on the other hand, we've got the interspecific relationships, that are relationships between different species. How are different species related? Okay, so now we've got four of them. We are going to study four of them. The first one is predation, that is when one organism kills another one to eat it. We have studied this lion hunting the wildebeest, and in this side we can see a carnivore plant eating a bee. Okay, so in this case the predator is happy because it's eating and the prey is killed. Okay, so it's not very happy. So it's not an equal relationship. Now we are going to see the parasitism. This is very important because it's when one organism lives in or on another called the host, okay? And the parasite always takes advantage of the host. In this case, we can see a flea on a dog, okay? Una pulga en un perro. The flea takes or eats the blood from the dog, okay? In this case, we can see this worm that has lots of parasites living on it. In some cases, these parasites can kill the host, okay? So this is not an equal relationship. The parasite gets benefits, but the host is damaged, okay? Okay, and now, the third one. This is very nice relationship. It's the mutualism. The mutualism are relationships that brings benefit to both organisms. So the two organisms are happy, are having benefits, okay? So in this case, we can see a crocodile. Can you see it? Yes. And the plover eats from crocodile's teeth. So all the things, the remainings of meat that the crocodile has, this little bird eats from it. So both are having benefits. In the other case, we can see here a bee taking the nectar from the flower. It takes the nectar from the flower, but the bee spreads, help the flower to spread the seeds, okay? So the flower can reproduce. It's important. So they both are getting benefits, okay? And on the other side, we've got here on the right the oxpecker that cleans the buffalo and eats its parasites. So there are lots of fleas and all these parasites that are on the buffalo that lives in the savanna, and this oxpecker eats them. So it cleans the oxpecker of these parasites, and both are having benefits of this, okay? And now we've got a very different relationship, that is symbiosis. Symbiosis is when two or more organisms work together to live. It's important. They couldn't live on their own. They need themselves, okay? Both are needed to live. This is what happens, you can see here, with the lichen, okay? The lichen are formed by the union of an algae and a fungus, okay? And they survive in very extreme climates thanks to this collaboration, to this relationship, okay? They work together to survive. So each one, in this case the algae and the fungus, gives something very important to the relationship, and they work together to survive. So this is an equality relationship. So we've got two equality relationships, that are symbiosis and mutualism, and two not equal relationships, that are parasitism and predation, okay? These are the interspecific relationships. Please study them. We are ending this unit, and soon we are going to have to prove that we have learned a lot. So please study. If you've got problems, just write me an email, and that's it. Thank you very much for being there. I hope everything's clear. See you, bye bye.